Your Christmas gift might actually arrive late this year, and here is why. Hey, what's up? My name is Ignace, Aleya, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how I caught Santa in real life on a dashcam. Alright, without further ado, the first thing that we need is our footage. And luckily, our main editor, Enzoe, went on a holiday last year and he went to Norway and still had dashcam footage on his SD card. So he actually gave us this footage to work with, which is absolutely magical and amazing, and that's where you would expect Santa to be at, so that's ideal. And the next thing that we'll need is Santa and his deers to fly through the air and passing on this shot. So how are we going to do that? Well, we'll need a Santa, and I found a free Santa model right here, which I then wanted to animate as him sitting down and looking around. So I downloaded this model, uploaded it to Mixamo, and Mixamo allows me to auto-rig my Santa model, and now I can choose from the library in Mixamo whatever I want. So I went for this sitting and looking around animation, which is great. Now I can download my Santa and import him in Cinema 4D, relinking all the textures using Redshift engine, and then I'm going to look for a sleigh model. Now I found this 3D sleigh model, which I'm also going to bring in Cinema 4D, again doing the entire texturing thing to make it look great using Redshift, and then I'm going to place my Santa in that sleigh, making sure that all the sizes fit and make it look realistic. And now I already have Santa in a sleigh. The next thing that I will need is the deers in front of the sleigh. And so for this, I actually searched a lot. I found a lot of deers, but the biggest problem was that they were either not free, which I wanted to do this in a DIY manner, or they were already in a pose, or they were not rigged, and I didn't really felt like rigging because it's not as simple as uploading to Mixamo and be done with it, because it's not a humanoid. It's not a character with two legs and two arms. It has four legs, and so this is going to be a different approach. So in this case, I will need to do the rigging myself. Luckily in Cinema 4D you have great presets for quadrupeds, or at least that's what I think they're called, but at least animals with four legs. And all you have to do is rig your character through this method and just make sure that everything matches on the dimensions of your model, just arranging everything in order, and at the end you will get something like this. And now I can bring this deer into my Santa scene, so I can then put this deer in a cloner and have a group of deers. Now I have my army of Santa's deers. So another thing that I want is for the deers to look like they're floating, just like I said before. And how do we do that? Well, we can add a random effector to the cloner. All that's going to do is offset the position. But if you set the randomize to a noise pattern, then you can actually animate the noise speed, and it's going to look like you're floating through this cloner, and it's going to look like they're going up and down if you have the settings right. So now I have something like this, which looks amazing. The only problem is that Santa is not doing the same yet. So for this, I'm going to apply a vibrate tag to my Santa sleigh to make it look like Santa is going up and down in a floaty manner. Again, you're not going to see all of these details, but I'm doing them anyway. There is something magical about doing all of the VFX work, and it's actually very common in the VFX industry where they put all of this effort into having everything working, but when you see the actual shot, you're not noticing anything. But still, it has that magical spark. I don't know how it works, but in the end, I think the shot looks a lot more dynamic by doing all of these steps anyway. So now that I have Santa and my deers floating, all I need more is for them to be connected using a rope. And luckily, in the recent update of Cinema 4D, this became a total breeze. They introduced rope dynamics, which basically means that you can add dynamic tags to splines, which is going to give you a breeze playing with rope dynamics. So if you want spaghetti, or if you want the deers from Santa to be connected, now is the moment. So all I've done is went to the top view, created a spline to match or to look like it's actually connecting through everything, and then I added rope dynamics to this tag, and that will make the rope fall. I also made sure that everything is very sticky, so when it falls and touches something, it's going to stick to it no matter what. Again, you could put more time and effort into this, but again, you're not really going to see that in my shot. I just wanted ropes to be in there, to have a dynamic feeling when they pass by, but you're not really going to notice if it's stuck to the neck or not, so I just let it be there. So after playing around with all the animation settings, I ended up with a really cool animation, and it's time to export to After Effects. in After Effects, I'm just going to bring this on top of my shot, and here it's basically matching your CGI to your original footage. My original footage is dashcam footage, so it looks crap, and my CGI looks perfect. So I also have to match that, and basically this process is called crapitization of your CGI footage. So I'm going to add in blurs, noise, stuff like that, also making sure that my contrast levels and my colors are all matching my original shot. And now I have this slate touching the floor, and that's actually because I want my CGI to make an interaction with my actual footage. That's the best way to make things look believable. I also added in some snow particles, and by the way, we're actually working on a bunch of products that you guys are going to be so excited about, but this is something for next year, so yeah, we'll talk about that later. Oh, and by the way, Hyun was so kind to send over this 24-inch tablet. And it's actually really beneficial, for example, when you're doing rotoscoping. And in this case, I rotoscope the buildings in the background, so this allows me to use this pen to key out everything. And just for some workflows, this makes it so much more fun and easier to work with. So if you'd like to find out more on the Hyun Canvas 24 tablet, link will be in the description below, and check it out for yourself. Anyway, I have this final shot, but I still felt like something was off. I could still add something, and that's something that I want you to think about. When you're finished with a shot, is there something you can do to give it that little extra oomph? And in our case, because he was touching the floor, I wasn't feeling it yet, just with sparks and smoke puffs. So I thought, wouldn't it be cool after having the bump that a package would actually fall out of the sleigh, which would be a logical thing to happen if you have a sleigh full of packages passing a bump. So again, that's exactly what I did. I animated a separate package to fall out of the sleigh and also added dynamics to my floor so it looks like it's actually falling to the street. And this is going to make everything interact even more and make my shot even more dynamic, because now we have a package falling onto my original footage, which is making everything blend together once more. At the end, after going through this a few more times and making sure that everything fits together perfectly, I got this final result. Enjoy. Alright, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, definitely give this video a like and also subscribe to the channel if you want to see more. Definitely hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. And apart from that, I'm going to leave you with another video of mine right here so you can continue your VFX journey. I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos. Merry Christmas, everyone.